Virgin Interactive Entertainment presents the Westwood Studios production of Lands of Lore, the Throne of Chaos.
My liege, it is as we feared. Scotia has uncovered the temple and will have the Nethermask soon.
We must be ready for her. She will come here first.
But Richard, what worry have we here at Gladstone? Surely we can arrange a defense against any charades.
The mask is not a toy. The time has come, and I have no choice. I must destroy her now.
She will be so pleased.
What can be taking so long? I want it now!
Your unholiness.
You will not make me wait again. Ah, it's a pretty little package. At last, Richard and his puny forces have met their match. Ah. I like this. Yes, this mask will serve me well. Beware, King Richard. You will pay for your lack of vision.
I have need of a champion. Who among you will volunteer to serve me in this matter?
Oh, it feels so good to be playing this again. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is Lands of Lore, the Throne of Chaos. And this is probably what I would consider to be my favorite game, if anyone were to ask and, like, force me to answer. This is a first-person dungeon crawler.
Excited.
It originally came out in 1993. We are playing the 1994 CD re-release with voiceovers by amazing actors such as Patrick Stewart, who's here for all of, like, 30 lines. We will just jump on in here. I'm going to be playing Kieran.
Magics. What good is it all if you can't dodge blows? I'm fast. Quick. Go with these lodestones if you plan to plot along. But if you want to win this quest, better pick me.
And we are playing as Kieran because he is actually the canonical hero of this. If you ever play the second game, which I wouldn't recommend to anyone, he is the one referenced as having saved the world in Rabble Rabble.
Excellent. Settle your affairs and attend me in the throne room for instructions.
Oh, this game is so amazing, you guys. I am so excited. This is one of the earliest Let's Plays on my YouTube channel, and...
Welcome to Gladstone Keep. King Richard awaits you in the throne room.
I am just so happy to be returning to it. I gotta do this. I have to do Anvil of Dawn, but the first thing that we're gonna do here is we're gonna save. And we're gonna dink around with options really quickly. First things first, I'm gonna... We'll turn down sound volume a little bit. But I want to turn on text. And what this is actually subtitles. So when people talk, it'll be down in the text window here. So like most old school crawlers, It's grid-based.
Yeren, where are you not summoned to see the king? Go back straight north into the throne room.
You'll get there. You can try to fight the guards, and it'll end poorly for you. You have equipment. You have sprites that are tentatively stolen from the days of Eye of the Beholder, but probably not. You have some levels. Skills in this go up based on use. So kill things with weapons and you level fighter, kill things with ranged weapons and you level rogue, kill things with magic and you level mage. And that is about all of the mechanical depth to this game. It's very, very simple compared to something even like Eye of the Beholder, which is not a particularly deep game. But when it comes to the old crawlers, I think this has the best presentation of any, and frankly, I think it stands with things that are released nowadays. It is just an absolutely gorgeous game. And the music is also really damn good. Let's go harass some people.
Shh. Did you hear something? If Scotia does attack, they say we won't hear a thing. Quickly now, point out what you need.
So to buy stuff, you just click on it and he'll tell us a price.
That salve is a secret Gorka recipe for healing.
That nope. We don't want any of this.
Farewell then.
We're gonna be blowing all of our money on weaponry, probably now, if I had to guess. Pester Victor.
Oh, so you come to see Victor, afraid of Scorcher's new toy. Why afraid? Look at Victor. Myself could use a shape changer.
Oh, Victor.
You show Victor what you want to buy. Maybe you show Victor what you sell, okay?
You're so charming, and at no point in the indeterminate future are you going to betray us.
Excellent weapon.
No.
You need that.
No.
That one.
We're eventually gonna buy this sword, maybe.
Then come visit. No?
We'll see. We can cast basic magic. We don't have the spell book yet, so all we can do is like a little shitty spark spell. And if you click on your bars, it tells you your health and mana. This is back from the days of super chunky interfaces, so, like, eventually we will have a spell book over here, we will have, like, a compass over here, and a map that we can click to open up over here, as well as a lantern, and our party will fill out this area of the, screen. And we're gonna ignore Jaren, because he's a dick. I don't even think he'll talk to us at this point.
Old tapestries glow with age.
His Royal Majesty awaits you in the throne room.
Okay. Let's go harass his royal majesty.
I tell you, we must march with whatever troops can be gathered locally.
Isn't Eric mustering his white army? Have we lost all confidence in our own military capabilities?
Eric is the finest commander in the kingdom, but he is a 5-day march from here.
As long as we have our own magic, I really don't see where we need more than the defenses we already have in place.
Scotia. Not an adversary to be taken lightly.
Ah, Kira. Because of the threat from Scotia, I have an urgent need for the Ruby of Truth. Please retrieve it from Roland's estate in the Southland and return it to Gladstone. Here is a key to my private library. Among the books, you will find a magic atlas that should be of assistance on your journey.
Come by my office before you leave the key. I'll give you a writ that will identify you as being on official business for His Highness.
Okay, so from left to right, those were King Richard on the left, the royal dickbag Jaren in the center, and the royal badass Dawn on the right. She is a sorceress, Jaren is useless.
Grandfather Ludwig.
And Richard is the king.
The early Talamari were mounted warriors.
And you can click on just about anything and they talk about it.
The kingdom looks deceptively peaceful.
It's amazing. So let's get us our little map book here.
And so it came to pass that the ancient people of Gladstone, having discovered a method of controlling the magics, rose unto power amongst the barbarous tribes of the Great Wasteland.
So there's one thing that comes with this game's CD version specifically called the Lore of the Lands, I believe, and it's basically just Patrick Stewart reading lore for like 20 minutes. It's pretty good.
The Magic Atlas.
Okay, so this gives us a mini-map. It doesn't really show us a lot because we haven't really seen a lot yet, but it has all of your usual accoutrements. It has map notes and stuff. I don't think you can add your own, but it will note down basically everything and anything that is important to you. It also shows you levers and hidden buttons.
Never drink from underground waters. These will corrupt the heart and taint the mind. Many a twisted soul met its fate through unwise drinking.
Okay.
For my part, I travel not to go anywhere, but to go. I travel for travel's sake.
King Richard reading civilization discovery texts.
Oh, it's you. The impending storm attracts all you would-be heroes. Now, I suppose you want your writ.
Alright.
Look, even the beasts seek shelter.
So, remember that this crow has golden eyes. That's a thing.
Mayhap that rascal Timothy is at the Grey Eagle.
Oh, that rascal Timothy. He's such a bro. And no, I haven't forgotten about going back for that sword. We will be. Just be patient. It'll happen. There should be a boar. Yes. There are not many games that I am confident in my ability to play through effectively. This is one of them, however. This is going to be a smooth run, probably from start to finish. I imagine there will be moderate bitching when we get to the part with the aliens where we have to pick a side and murder everyone else, but that's mostly because it's such a huge waste of time. That having been said...
Hey you! I'm taking your money!
No.
You won't get my money without a fight.
And bees! Oh, the swarms are the best thing ever. So, early on, in like the intro-expository text, Kieran mentioned that he can dodge blows. That is bullshit. He has no better chances to dodge than anyone else in the game. He's just trying to sell himself and how he has the lowest stats of anyone by a pretty good margin. I think X-Shell is probably my favorite start.
Hmm. What would a beautiful young woman be doing on a road like this?
Excuse me, lad. Are you with King Richard? I need to get into the keep, and I have forgotten the password. May I go in with you?
I'm sorry, miss, but these are dangerous times.
Timid fool. I will not forget you.
Golden eyes. She's everywhere. And this is nothing.
Red is much too cold for swimming this time of year.
For now. So there's a little bit you can poke around in out here.
The hollow.
Like, sometimes there will be goodies in, like, the knot holes of trees.
There are silver coins in here!
Yeah, we found some money. Okay, and I think...
The nest is empty.
This is, like, totally not going to eventually be an entrance to a dungeon. Nope. So there is one side area we can go. This is for continuing the plot. We're gonna do that later. We have a side area to explore first.
Why are thugs guarding that cave?
I don't know, we'll have to introduce them to some bees!
Get out of here!
I love it, it's like I'm attacking and they're just like, hey! Go home! You fucking LARPer! And then we just accost them with swarms of insect death. And magical- God! The low tier spark spell is garbage. Well, we should- if I had more mana, now is a good time to train it, but... Oh... Like, I could retreat us back in... I could retreat us back into, like, Castle Gladstone and rest to get our mana back, and then come out and zap these guys. And there might be a little bit of mage leveling for that later in, but I'm gonna try to keep that to a minimum because it's mostly unnecessary.
There are silver coins in here. A lantern.
Alright. A torn shirt, which is worse than what we have on, and another dagger, and a pressure plate, and a button, and a key. So I believe... So we pick this up, put it here, there we go.
Rubbish.
Rubbish, filth.
There are silver coins in here.
Rubbish.
Okay, we'll go down that side passage. Let's see, and we have a button. And a button, and a button, and we use the key. We get some lockpicks, and a bezel cup, and some salve. Alright, so the bezel cup and the salve are actually pretty good. The bezel cup's a full heal, salve is a moderate heal. Aloe is like a crappy little heal, and I believe ginseng heals poison. One of these two cures poison, I can never remember which. We won't be using them, ideally. And lockpicks let you pick locks. Your ability to pick locks is based purely on your rogue level. I want to say if you get a rogue level of 6, you can pick every lock in the game. If you don't mind hammering on the lock picking button. It might be level 7. But we probably won't go that route. It's a pain in the ass to kill that many things with ranged weapons. It's easier once you get this crossbow called Valkyrie. It shoots fireballs. They do, like, no damage, but they never miss. So you can, like, soften things up and then kill them with a crossbow.
This must be the marina. This must be the marina. Excuse me, I need to book passage to the Southland.
Where's your money?
I have a writ from the king.
Where is it? Didn't your mother teach you any manners?
I'm trying to give you the writ, wench.
Well then, hurry and get on the boat.
Jesus, fucking people. So we will be getting that sword once we get back from here. Because we're going to be looting everything. Money's not really a problem in this game outside of, like, now, so it'll be okay. And one thing that I also want to say is I'm not necessarily going to go for super long episodes on this beyond, like, 20-30 minutes, but I might, as I have time, do multiple uploads in a given day because I want to get through this kind of quickly.
This is the Gray Eagle.
So if you see, like, two episodes of this going up a day, no, I didn't screw anything up. I'm just throwing extra videos out there for y'all.
This looks cozy.
My wife won't let me keep those in the house.
This inn seems well supplied. I'd hate to have this fellow's wax bill.
Please, don't bother my customers.
This room is occupied.
Are you by chance Timothy of Gladstone?
No, I am Philip. Timothy is the yellow-haired fellow over by the fire there.
Thank you. I'm on an important mission for King Richard.
Well, you're a brave young patriot, sonny. Take this magnet stone to guide you on your journeys. Long live King Richard.
And there's our compass.
Are you Timothy of Gladstone?
No, I'm Tyrus, but you're close.
Are you by chance Timothy of Gladstone?
Yes, I am Timothy. And who might you be?
I am Kieran. King Richard has sent me to retrieve the Ruby of Truth from Sir Roland. One of the Dark Army spies has a mask or something. She's become a shape-changer and apparently threatens the kingdom.
Scotia, she is the most evil woman alive. I heard that she had hired the excavators, but I never dreamed she'd actually find the mask. Well then, Kieran, let's go now. I'll get my things together and meet you outside.
Alright. So you can see, we now have our little compass.
I am pleased to join you, sir. All I have is at your disposal.
Thanks, Timothy. I'm immediately going to strip you of all of your gear and take it for my own, because at no point are you going to be yanked forcefully from my party and then murdered by a horde of orcs. So the downside to Kieran, as you can see here, he can't wear boots. Kieran just kinda sucks. So he's gonna have crappier defense than basically everybody else for the rest of the game. It's just the way of things. But you can see here that Timothy, comparatively, is kind of a badass. So let's poke around. There should be giant lizards around here that need killing and will yield experience points. Alright, there's a shop right there, which I guess we can stick our nose into. I think it's Buck.
Hello! Come on in, I'm Buck. Here to trade, just show me what you got or what you want.
Alright, he has nothing we care about. I think we can, like, buy boots. We might be able to buy a... Actually, I don't think we can buy a bow. Can we buy a bow?
Would you sell that?
Sure. 100 crowns.
No. I don't care that much about thief training. Yeah, watch out for the orcs. More bees. Bees make every situation better. Okay. So let's find some lizards. There should be... This is where we came in. There should be one back here. No. I know there's one at the end of, like, a tunnel. I don't know why I'm taking rocks. I don't think we can sell them. But damn it. Oh, this is the map, by the way. And this is what I mean where I said it tells you, like, everything you need to know. The map in this game is fucking great. It's about as good as you can get with a map that doesn't let you write on it. All right, so these things you have to be careful with because they do, like, this ground stomp and it'll make us drop all of our stuff. That is bad. We also want to avoid letting... We also want to avoid letting Timothy get any kills, because by doing so, we are missing out on XP. And this game does not have a finite amount of experience points to it, but at the same time in the early game here, every kill helps, so you level really quickly in these early levels. And I'm not going to go out of my way to, like, starve Timothy for experience or anything, but whoop! But we're given the chance. I'll kind of dance around things and see about letting Kieran get the kills here. So the other thing is that I believe using swarms and killing things with them will net you magic XP. We'll test it once we bump into some orcs. But as you can see, the circle strafe to victory strategy works very, very well in this. And it is something that we will be leaning on quite heavily for basically the entirety of the game. And I keep getting turned around. We want to go... No, that's the inn. Here? Yeah. This just dead ends, but we get more bees. And I was just saying, there's another lizard back here. Let's just pitch rocks at it. Set Timothy as a... Ah, shit. Get out of here! Timothy, bees! Alright, did that net you XP? Yeah, it did! You can see his mage XP went up a little bit. It'll be easier once we have access to, like, the freeze spell, which will be in a little while. It'll be after, like, the first baby tier dungeon. Seriously, man? You eating my knives or my rapiers? We will kill this thing and it will give it back. There are monsters in this that do destroy gear, and if there's going to be any save scumming, that would be when it happens. Ideally, we won't, though. Hey, a mace. Well, that is an upgrade for Timothy. This is why it's worth hanging around and killing the orcs. They do drop things that you can vendor. I believe that there are a finite number of things that they can drop, and if there's not, there's a finite number of objects that the map can actually hold. And there's one dungeon in the very end of the game. Well, I should say it's not the dungeon. The very last area of the game. Maps have, like, an entity limit on them. So you can only have, like, you know, so many things in a map. Items, monsters, etc. And there is one map where that entity limit can be hit. And if you throw things, like, you can lose gear permanently. That is a lot of orcs. We may need to employ some healing here momentarily. Maybe not. Ooh, fuckers throwing knives? What is this? He's nearing a fighter level. Levels in this, especially early on, give you substantial boosts to, like, your health and stuff. Alright, we're gonna try to sleep here. I did not mean to go in. Buck, I never mean to come in here. Will you buy this shitty ratty shirt off me, though?
Not really interested in buying that.
What about knives? Really. No. Buck, you're useless. Victor would buy those.
Watch out for the orcs!
Garbage. Alright, we're gonna save and we're gonna try sleeping. Oh no! Orc tried. But yeah, like... Character progression in this game is kind of weird. Like, Michael, for example, he is by far the worst spellcaster in the beginning of the game. But due to how the leveling works, he can actually end up being the best spellcaster because of the, like, absurd rate that he excels when it comes to acquiring spell points on level up. Like, Exshell is the dedicated spellcaster character, and I believe Michael, as you play through the game, will end up with more spell points than he has. It's just, it's crazy, it's weird. I'd be curious to see, like, some actual mechanics as to how it works. Ah, there you go, we finally pulled something useful out of a tree. Tentative poison cure. It's worth clicking on everything.
What happened?
Uh-oh.
Someone has attacked.
That means we should save, because surely nothing bad has happened to Roland. Ow. You jerk. I think there's one of them behind us. There's gotta be one of them. Yeah, there's one of them behind us. Bees! God, bees fix everything. Oh, he's like right there! I'm gonna try sleeping. The rest times are pretty excessive in the early game. Once we get later in, there are better healing spells that we'll have access to that'll, like, let me full heal the party and stuff, and it expedites things quite substantially. Alright, so this needs to be the Kieran show here, because he should ding second level for killing these guys, and that would be nice. There we go, 35 hit points. So he went up like 13 hit points? I think he was at 22? Either 22 or 28. Regardless, more hit points, good. And he needs them. Like I said, there's a boss fight of sorts in here. And I think that there's a secret.
These scones are firmly attached.
I think you mean sconces.
And the game does have a sense of humor. It's amazing. I love it. So we have some oil flasks so we can fill our lantern. Just don't even bother ever picking these up. Your lantern should never, ever run out of fuel. If anything, carry like one of them. And even if your lantern is doused, it's not that dark. It's mostly just a convenience more so than anything. Alright, we got a guy in here. Seriously, dude? Come on, there we go. Alright. Uh-oh.
You small, what you?
We kill.
You shall perish by my hand.
You tell him, Catboy. And then immediately just get the ever-living god beaten out of you. And once more, I'm getting stuck into Ultima Underworld 2's controls and, like, trying to back up with the wrong buttons. It's hilarious. We gotta be careful with this dude because he throws knives. Alright, we'll heal Kieran up here. This isn't, like, a particularly difficult fight. It's just meandering, I guess. I'm gonna try to hit him with some death magic here momentarily. Well, there we go. It's like a point of damage right there, man. It's better to fight this guy in an area like this because you don't have to be, like, strafing backwards from his throwing knives. And again, this would be nice if I could get... I could get this kill for Kieran, and I did.
There are silver coins in here.
Axes in these games suck. I don't know why, but they're terrible. We are going to be using swords for basically the entirety of this game. Let's go ahead and have a nap while we look outside and see about maybe finding Roland. Alright. Let's see here.
This is Roland's hiding place. I hope he is in here.
Oh, he is.
Roland, what has happened?
Timothy, the Dark Army passed through here not an hour ago. They have stolen the Ruby of Truth.
We will take you to Gladstone with us. Dawn will heal your wounds.
I am beyond healing. You too must recover the Ruby.
The war has begun, Kieran. The death of such a patriot must be avenged. Let us hasten back to Gladstone.
I vow upon his deathbed to find these orcs and return the Ruby to Gladstone.
Yeah, we'll avenge him right after looting everything he owned.
If I don't take these coins...
Okay, so we got some coins, and we got a saber, which... is pretty crap. So we're just gonna go ahead and take everything from Timothy. And we will get back... We'll get back to, I don't even know the land where Gladstone is.
Hello? Are you going north?
I had a writ from the king, but that other clerk kept it. May I still ride?
Sorry. 100 crowns per passenger? Hurry, the boat is just leaving.
Alright. That other clerk, proving that she is just a raging dick, took our writ of passage and cost me 200 gold pieces worth of gear. Damn it. Alright.
You may pass. What tidings bring you from the Southland?
The Dark Army has stolen the Ruby. I must tell King Richard.
His Highness is resting in the throne room.
Yes, but first we must harass Victor and acquire new stabbing implements. I think they'll be better than the rapier. I think the longsword is better than the rapier. Fairly certain.
You again come to see Victor.
No, buy my crap. All of it.
Fine. That.
Will you buy my shirt?
You need for.
Totally will!
You need for
Victor sale. Does not give a shit. The man will buy anything.
Fine.
150 for that axe. What about a stick?
That not
worth. Ah, oh, I tried.
Maybe you have something else.
You could hit Jaren with it. I'm sure it would break before his head did, though.
Fine work. That.
You can also buy lockpicks here. That's what those are right back there. I don't suppose you will buy rocks.
That.
I had to try.
You have something else.
There is something you can do with sticks later in the game, but I will probably show it to you, but I don't intend on, like, hoarding them for anything. All right, give me the fancies. Will you sell me this one?
Not for sale. This commander's sword.
Oh.
Excellent.
Give me the longsword. All right.
You again come visit. No?
Okay, so the other one was, like, I think 16? And this is 19. Not a huge upgrade, but an upgrade nonetheless. And on that note...
Do you have the Ruby of Truth?
The ruby has been stolen. I must see King Richard.
Go in at once.
I'm going to go ahead and call it here. And I will see you guys next time, wherein we go and let King Richard know, and surely nothing bad will happen. Until then...